I will keep them in perfect peace, whose mind is stayed on me. Some people are depressed because their thinking is in the wrong hands. You know, here God says, whatsoever things are lovely, whatsoever things are honest, whatsoever things are pure, let you hear him say, if there be any virtue, and if there be any praise, think on these things. The reason why you feel violated and you feel cheap is because where my sisters are to put your body in the wrong hand. Or can I go to somebody? Don't worry, I'll be finished in a minute. For the past 20 years, you don't get nothing out of your life because you put your future in the wrong hands. But I came by to tell somebody, it's time for you to start trusting the hands of your potter. Stop chasing after other things and chase the God who chase after you. Oh, is there anybody in here that understand that if you ever find yourself in the potter's hand, it would change your life. I wish I had one witness. I'm getting ready to close. But you want to understand, if you stay in God's hands, you're going to be better. And I want you to understand, sometimes it's not easy staying in God's hands. For the devil try to get you out of God's hands. But you got to make a decision. Amen. Every now and then, I tell folk, I like to give the devil a Jerry Springer update. You are not the father. Don't tell me what to do. Don't tell me where to go. I have a God that is leading me in the path that I must go. So you must stay in God's hand, even though you may not get yet what you prayed for. Sometimes it looks like it's taking a long time, but remember, no good thing will he withhold from them that walk uprightly. Stay in God's hands. When people are laughing at you about how you conduct yourself like a Christian, and let them know that there's a way that seemeth right to a man, but the end of life is the ways of death. Amen. Stay in God's hand, even when you feel forsaken, because even when mother and father forsake you, God will take you up. I heard Paul says, I'm troubled on every side, but not distressed, but persecuted, but not in despair. Amen. Persecuted, but not forsaken, cast down, but not destroyed. I have this treasure in earthen vessel. Excuse me, I've got to stay in God's hand, even when I don't have the amount of friends I used to have when I was in the world. Is there any witness? But I heard God says, whatever you leave in this world for God, in this life, you're going to receive it 100-fold. Is there any witness in here? I want somebody to know, you need to stay in God's hand, even when life seems to be moving slowly, because they that wait on the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. The eagle wings are so engineered that he just mounts up, and somebody's getting ready to just mount up. Do me a favor, let God elevate you. Let the haters know. Don't you know haters? The heights of great man reach and kept, but not again my son and friend. I wish I had a witness in here. Stay in God's hand, even when you're rebuked, even when you're chastised, because whom the Lord loves, he rebukes. Stay in God's hands, even even when you're persecuted and tried and criticized. Because if you humble yourself under the mighty hand of God, He will exalt you in due time. And cast your cares upon Him, for He cares for you. I want broken vessels all around this room to know that God can make something beautiful out of you. Shake your neighbor and say, are you in good hands? I love God's hands. I said, I love God's hands. God turned lawbreakers into yoke breakers. He turned people who were sinister and made them into ministers. He turned people who were stalkers and turned them into pastors. He turned people who were iniquity workers and made them into miracle workers. He transformed homosexuals into heterosexuals. He gave convicts and made them converts. He take mess ups and make them bishops. Do you know what I'm talking about? My God, take somebody who was hell bent and make them heaven bound. He take somebody who was fickle and turn them into an apostle. That is the God that we serve. He's able to reshape prostitutes to prophetesses. He turned murderers into missionaries. He turned thieves into philanthropists. He turns haters into praisers. He turns gang leaders into church leaders. He turns rum drinkers into creative thinkers. He turns street fighters into planet warriors. He turns terrorists into evangelists. I want you to know there is not one broken vessel. There's not one broken vessel that God can make. I don't care how deep you are in. I don't care how broken you are. He picks up the pieces time and time again. So in case you are falling by the wayside of life, Jews and Jesus suffer. You are broken inside. You don't have to stay. You don't have to stay. We just have 10 minutes. But listen to me. I've been in church long enough to see the results of people who came out of God's hands. It's a horrible sign. They came out of God's hands, went into the hands of the devil. Because the devil have good advertisement. Yes. Young people, you know what the enemy use that catch us? Excitement. Excitement. And the excitement is just for a time. Yes. God already revealed what the enemy will do to you.
Oh, yes.
If the enemy gets you in his hand.
Yes.
He told Peter, he said, Peter, Satan desired to have a shamba that he can shift you like wheat. Wake up in the morning, you don't know yourself. You're doing things you don't understand, damaging yourself, you don't understand. He's sifting you. And I've seen people in the devil's sleep and would not come back to God's hand. He said to Israel, what iniquity have you found in me?
or your father's father's home, that you come after them and become better. The result of your life, where your life is right now, is a direct result of the hands you find yourself in. It's a direct result of the hands you find yourself in. And some people couldn't wait on God. They couldn't wait on God. They run off from God to chase Prince Charming. And then you found that Prince Charming wasn't really that charming. Don't you think God knows who is good for you? He knows who is good for you. He knows what is good for you. He knows what will bless you and what will drive you crazy. And sometimes God said no and risked you being upset with him so that 5 years later you are not losing your mind. And I thank God for the doors he shut. I thank God for the doors he shut, because I would have walked through the wrong door. But when you are in his hands, when you are in his hands, he will make sure you are blessed. He will make sure you are. Listen, you don't need to run down promotion. Promotion come not from the east, nor the west, nor the south. God is the judge. He set that up. Why? Take down another. When you become intimate with God, and when you begin to chase after God, the things that other people chase after will chase you. I'm through, but is there one tonight that you're broken? You're broken. I'm inviting you down to this house. Your life is completely upside down. You found yourself in really bad hands. There is a woman that had an issue of blood, and she suffered so many things of so many physicians, and she was nothing better. There are a lot of people in the world that are trying so many physicians, and they can't make them better. Because the only person that can fix what's broken with you is God. Is God. Is there one tonight? Quickly. We're almost out of time. We want to pray with you.